This is the Chevy Silverado EV, and today we're gonna check out the feature specs and the interior, and we're gonna see how it compares to the F-150 Lightning. I think you'll be rather surprised, and we're gonna ask GM some questions. This is a brand new clean slate design. This actually shares nothing with the Silverado HD, and I think that gives it a real sort of futuristic vibe. Let me know what you think of it down in the comments. So this brand new architecture gives them a lot of freedom. This has the Ultium 24 module battery pack. It is down low and these batteries are stacked on top of each other. And so this is now integrated into the entire structure, the architecture of this body. So it's not a body on frame like the F-150 Lightning, which is sort of a more old school design. This is a brand new design and a lot of people are talking about it like it is the old Avalanche, but it's actually just completely coincidental. And this paint color is super awesome. They don't have a name for it yet, but maybe we can name it. Let's talk about the range and the battery pack because everyone wants to know this. So they say that this is gonna have a range of 400 miles and we don't know the size of the battery pack, but this is probably about 200 kilowatt hour battery pack because this shares the same architecture essentially as the Hummer, and that is a 200 kilowatt hour battery pack. So I'm just kind of guessing. Now I'm gonna have my phone out here because I'm comparing specs and I can't remember everything, but the F-150 does not have the same range as this. The top level F-150 has a battery pack of 131 kilowatt hours and a range of 320 miles. So plus 80 miles. On paper, this is a big win over the F-150. Let's talk about charging speed. So this is able to charge at 350 kilowatts. And let me just compare how fast that is again against the F-150 Lightning. That truck is able to charge at 150 kilowatts. So in terms of the actual amount of miles that you can add 100 miles in 10 minutes on this, and the F-150 Lightning, about 54 miles. So this is almost double the amount of charging speed. So this is gonna charge realistically a whole lot faster when you're on the road than the F-150 Lightning. This is pretty much at the top tier right now of charging speed of electric vehicles. Let's talk about power and torque. So this is the RST trim. This is the top trim, and most of the specs I'm talking about in this video are gonna be from the top trim. So of course this is all-wheel drive, and how do they do it? With two separate motors. So we got a motor in the back, we got a motor in the front. And so in this trim, we're gonna get 664 horsepower and 780 pound-feet of torque, which is a heck of a lot. And on the F-150 Lightning, we're talking 563 horsepower, 775 pound-feet of torque. Now, we don't really know what the weight of this is. We know that the F-150 Lightning is gonna be somewhere around 6,200 to 6,600 pounds. I can speculate on this, but I don't really know what it's gonna be. It's probably gonna be a little bit heavier is my guess. So I'm thinking the power to weight ratio is gonna be pretty similar, but man, these new trucks have a lot of power. We're talking 0 to 60 in 4.5 seconds. So on the WT model, which stands for work truck, which is a much lower trim than this, we're talking about 510 horsepower and 615 pound-feet of torque. So still a lot of torque, a lot of power. The target price for that is gonna be somewhere around $40,000. Target price for this is a little over 100, about 105. So this is gonna be a much more expensive vehicle. And talking about when you can get these vehicles, the work truck is gonna be targeted for spring of 23, and this is gonna be sometime around the fall. Okay, so we have something called onboard power. So in the bed, we have three ports over here and three over there. These are regular 120 volt AC ports. You could use this to power power tools, a stereo system, a blender, whatever you want. And also, you can use this to charge another electric vehicle. It's called bi-directional charging. So let's say I've got another electric vehicle, let's say my Chevy Bolt, and I want to charge it, I can use this over here, this 1772 connector, and charge my Chevy Bolt. And I can also use this to power my house too, as long as you've got the appropriate infrastructure at your house, the appropriate wiring panel, and so forth. So everybody wants to know, can you tow with this? And yes, you can. And so how much can you tow? 10,000 pounds on this RST. This is gonna come with a class 5 hitch. On the work truck, it's gonna be 8,000 pounds. And what's really cool is that they're saying on a future version of the work truck, 20,000 pounds of towing, which is absolutely class leading. That's higher than anyone else at this point. It's also going to have a system that's going to allow you to back up your trailer, which is good because I suck at backing up long trailers. So on the F-150 Lightning, depending on the package, it's going to be around 7,700 to 10,000 pounds also. So very, very competitive with this, but 20,000 pounds is something I want to see. Let's talk about suspension, and this is where there's a big advantage over the F-152. This has something called adaptive air suspension, and so this is going to have a total travel of 4 inches. So if you're going off-road, if you're in a snowy conditions, you're going to be able to go 2 inches up or 2 inches down. Now this does have 24-inch wheels and tires here. This is probably going to be optional. These are huge. These are 275, 50, R24. Let's talk about the turning circle, compare these. So this is a little trick. This will actually, the turning circle is 42 feet and 2 inches. That's about 5 feet better than the F-150, which is about 47 feet. And you know how they do it? Something called four-wheel steering. So at low speeds, when you're parking this thing, you're gonna be able to turn the wheels in the same direction and make the turning circle smaller. And on the freeway, they're gonna be able to turn in a different direction for stability. So this is going to work at low speed and high speed. We don't know much about the system yet, but I'm going to speculate it's some kind of servo type system. We can't really see anything though, because this is all kind of closed off. All right, so this is the interior, and we're finally allowed to sit in it, but I'm going to be very, very careful because this is a production intent vehicle, which means this is not even quite pre-production yet, but this is what Chevrolet intends to bring us to market. So this is representative. Sorry for the fan noise. This is something that can't be turned off. So over here, we have a 17-inch display for your infotainment system, and it's very big and it's very bright. It's very nice looking. This is just running on a loop, so you can kind of get a sense of what the screen looks like. In front of the driver, we have another screen, the driver information screen, which is 11 inches. It is really quite bright. And then there's a heads-up display from the driver over here too, coming out of here, and I think this is going to be about 14 inches or so. So you can see we got a backup camera system over here. And what I like is we have a lot of physical controls for the heating and ventilation. Yes, that's something that some manufacturers have decided to drop. So I really like that. And in the center of this console here, we have, or actually it's right over here, this is able to hold 7 gallons of stuff. So you could put a lot of purses, you could put a little cooler in there. And let's just talk about my impression of the interior, this being the RST trim. This is a really nice, futuristic looking interior. Like the wheel, it's nice and big. These seats are comfortable. These seats are heated and cooled, front and back. And something that you get here, which you don't get in the F-150, is you get this beautiful panoramic glass sunroof, moonroof, whatever you want to call it. There's a lot of space in here. This is a really premium looking interior. So let's take a look in the back. So we have this nice step up step, which I'm not gonna step on just because this is not production. And we have got a ridiculous amount of knee room here. Oh my God, there's a good 2 feet of knee room. I'm 5'9". I could sit behind myself easily. And they're able to do this because of this Ultium battery pack. You don't have the transmission tunnel. You don't have all the regular constraints that you do in a normal truck. So we've got a lot more space up here, and they're able to move these front seats up, able to make the nose a little bit shorter and give this a ton of interior space. This is super comfortable. I could sit in the middle as well, and you can easily fit. It's not the most comfortable seat here, but this is a good 5-passenger truck. No question. You've got heating and ventilation back here too, which is really nice. I've also got some controls over here for the airflow. I've got a couple of cup holders, and I'm assuming that there's something that folds down in here, but this is, you know, again, this is not a production truck, so I'm not gonna mess with it. I'm gonna let them touch it. So this is Shad Balch, Director of Communications, and I got a couple questions for you about this very interesting truck. So where is this gonna be built?
So this will be built in our Detroit facility. It's called Factory Zero. It's where the current Hummer EV is built. So this will be built alongside that.
Right, and what about, you have a separate battery plant too?
So the Ultium platform is, it's also built in, components come from different places, but it's all assembled in Detroit at the Factory Zero plant.
Towing, typically with an EV, I'm seeing reports from other manufacturers that we're getting a reduction in range. So how will that be communicated to the driver?
So in the same way, when you're towing with a gas-powered vehicle, your fuel economy drops. The same thing will happen with an electric vehicle. So we'll be sure to provide a lot of information to the driver so that they can see exactly how big that drop is. And the biggest thing that we need to give the customers is the ability to predict their range at the end so that they know when to pull over and charge. So there'll be a lot of information that is provided to the driver so there's no surprise when they are towing that their battery is not getting as much range as they might expect.
Because one of the challenges, I think, when you're on the road with an EV and towing is you go over hills. That's going to be a very different scenario than if you're towing through a flat plain, you know, so your range is going to drop like quite significantly.
Yeah, it's very true. I mean, there's a lot of parameters that impact the vehicle range, even just from driver to driver. The way that they drive the vehicle will impact the range, and weather conditions and your speed. If you're going slower or faster, that will impact your range. So a lot of factors come into play.
So what are the target customers for this? Who's going to buy this truck?
So eventually, our goal is to get everybody to move from a gas-powered vehicle into a zero-emission vehicle or an EV. So eventually, it's going to be every truck customer that we have. Obviously, we're right now in the transition phase of trying to get people to understand the benefits of driving an electric vehicle and a truck application especially. So this particular truck is geared towards sort of like the early adopter, the people who need a truck. They use a truck for all that it delivers in terms of capability, but also want to have the latest in technology. And an EV truck like this that's purpose-built from the ground up, this is the best way to show them the benefits of EV technology, especially in a pickup truck. So for now, it's sort of like the truck drivers who are also early adopters.
So you're starting with the work truck as the first entry, basically, and then the RST. What's the thinking of that? Like, why the work truck? Because that's a more difficult customer, quite frankly.
Yeah, well, there's several different reasons about why we're going after our fleet customers first. One is they're a very important group for us. Fleet customers will be able to look at the trucks and maintain, service the trucks with them directly, and really tailor the electric vehicle application in a pickup truck to the real world needs of what our fleet customers provide. I mean, they use these trucks for everything. So it'll really give us a lot of insight and a lot of engineering know-how about what the best way to engineer these trucks for retail customers going forward.
So you've got something called the Ultium Charge 360 program. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, this is basically, it's for our fleet customers. It gives them access to a charging network that we are a partner of. So basically, it'll provide all the information about charging locations, the current state of those chargers, whether or not they're working or in use, to the customers in the vehicle. So it's just basically the information network of the charging infrastructure that we have partnered with.
So one of the objections I hear from people is that the battery is going to die after a couple of years. That's a very common misconception. I know other manufacturers have 10-year warranties on their batteries that say we're going to get a certain amount of percentage of usable battery after 10 years. What's your plan for this?
So specific for this truck, we'll have information on what the warranty looks like as we get closer to launch. But what I can tell you is that we've been in the battery electric vehicle game for quite a long time. Longer than most. And in fact, when we came out with our Gen 1 Volt, you'll recall that battery had a 10-year, 150,000-mile warranty with it, and their degradation rate was very low. So we know batteries. We're very deliberate in the way that we treat the batteries in terms of thermal management to ensure that they get, you know, a long life, a long use.
How many of these are you hoping to produce in the first year or two?
Well, as many as we can. We have 140,000 reservations in so far, where customers have put down a deposit. We're going to try and build as many as we can to meet demand, but unfortunately, I can't get into too many specifics on volume yet.
Anything else you want to tell us about this truck that we might not know?
I mean, this is very important for GM. Having an electrified pickup truck, the pickup trucks are very important to the company. They are what we are known for. And as part of the company's commitment to get, you know, zero emissions, zero congestions, and zero collision, this is a big step in that direction. So we're very excited to get in the marketplace.
So in terms of pricing, the work truck is going to start at about $40,000. This RST, this is the first edition. This is going to be over 100, probably 105. This is fully loaded. This first edition is going to be a little bit tough to get. We're going to have other trims from about 50, 60, 70, 80. And let's talk about the F-150 Lightning price-wise. Now, it's kind of similar. We start at about $40,000 for the Pro, which has less power than this does. Then we got Platinum at the top end. It's about $90,000. But Let's just talk quickly about this comparison that we're doing with the F-150 Lightning and this truck over here. In terms of specs, this wins in so many different categories. Specifically, we're talking about range, where this has 400 miles of range on the top trim, and that has 320 miles of range, and also charging speed. That charges at 150 kilowatts, this charges at 350. I can tell you I own an EV, and that is a huge difference, being able to add that amount of miles when you're on the freeway, when you're at a road stop, at your charging location, being able to add 100 miles in 10 minutes, that is huge. So this is a more, I guess, forward-facing truck, I would say. This is definitely a more sophisticated looking truck. It definitely looks more futuristic. It sort of depends what you like. And we've got this very interesting mid-gate over here. We've also got a very interesting tailgate. Ethan's gonna talk about that in his video from Hello Road. So click over here for that video. Thanks for watching.